Hello everyone, I'm Sophie and I'm one of the science kids. Today we're going to be talking about two of my favorite subjects combined, robots and small stuff. Now, what exactly is this field? This field is a subsection of technology called nanotechnology. Well, what exactly is this field? Well, in order to understand what nanotechnology is, we need to understand what its name is composed of, nano and technology. The word nano means 1/1,000,000th of, so a nanometer is 1/1,000,000th of a meter. That sounds really small, but it doesn't really do justice to how small it is. Here's a scale that represents how big a human is on average. Now let's go smaller, and smaller, and even smaller, and even smaller than that. And here we are. That is a nanometer. I know, crazy. So what is nanotechnology? Well, nanotechnology is exactly what it sounds like. It's computers, circuits, robots, and technology, but at the nanoscale. Well, how would you even make a nanorobot?
The idea behind nanotechnology is that as computers and circuits become smaller, they become harder to make. So nanotechnology provides an alternative by allowing scientists to create these computers and circuits by manipulating chemicals and molecules.
At the chemical level, chemicals can be manipulated in many different ways to do different things. Some of the most obvious and coolest forms of this are structural isomers. Let's take, for example, this molecule. It's composed of 6 carbons, 12 hydrogens, and 6 oxygens. We know this molecule as glucose. This is what glucose's structure looks like. Now here's another chemical. This is fructose. It has a different structure than glucose, but it has the same chemical formula? That doesn't make any sense. Well, in fact, it does make sense, because there are many different types of chemicals just like glucose and fructose, which have the same chemical formula, but have a different structure. These are called structural isomers. So what exactly is the significance of these structural isomers? Well, as you know, computer data and information is transmitted in the form of binary. That means zeros and ones. What this tells us is that anything that can be represented in two different forms, on and off, true or false, 0 or 1, can represent binary information. So at the chemical level, going back and forth between glucose and fructose, or any structural isomers, can represent binary data. Now, this is not the only form of chemical manipulation studied by nanotechnologists. There are many other forms of chemical manipulation. For example, applying energy in the form of electricity or heat to make objects move, or using self-assembling monolayers, which are methods of sensing contact or movement at the chemical level. And things like this are slowly coming to reality. I mean, check out this nano car. This car has buckyball wheels and alkaline axles, and at 300 degrees Celsius, it can travel 12 million times its length in 1 minute. That's crazy.
Just imagine the applications of this field. In fact, if you guys come up with one, please drop them in the comments below. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video. Stay tuned for our next few videos. Don't forget to check out our social media and links down below. And as always, science is everywhere and in everything. Bye.